Hi folks, this is David Kwan here. I hope you guys enjoyed celebrating Thanksgiving, if you do celebrate Thanksgiving. If not, I hope you guys enjoyed time off from work, because that's usually for a lot of people, they can do that. For those of you who have jobs that doesn't allow you to get a time off from Thanksgiving, I know, my parents have jobs that also is like that. You know, my dad's a pastor. He's always done stuff for Thanksgiving that required his obligations at the church. And my mom is a nurse. So nurses, depending on your shift and your schedule, often don't get their day off for Thanksgiving. So yeah, I know that there are people out there that do have jobs that doesn't allow them to have Thanksgiving off. So anyway, for those people, my heart goes out to you. But anyway, I hope it was a great, fun Thursday and Friday and this weekend for you guys. Over the years, I think my relationship with Thanksgiving Day as a whole, it's kind of faltered off. I think last year I talked about how my problem with the holiday in general with Thanksgiving. This year, I was planning to go to my parents' place. They just recently moved, so I can finally say it. This was kind of confidential for a while because there was a lot of tentative stuff in the making, but now I can say it without being in trouble and say it in public. So my parents now live in Iowa. They used to live in Tennessee, but now they live in Iowa. So I haven't seen their new place yet because they moved with me in New York. So I was planning to go visit them in Iowa for this year's Thanksgiving, but then the problem was money. I should have booked much earlier the travel, but I figured, you know, they normally don't raise bus prices. Bus fare is usually the same if you book it tomorrow or if you book it a month in advance, usually. But I guess this year, or maybe it's just Thanksgiving in general, I don't think I've ever booked a bus fare ticket for Thanksgiving. But this year, they doubled the bus fare. So it was way too expensive for me to go visit my parents. The whole price in total was like $450 for a round trip to Iowa and back on a bus. You know, that's not a plane fare, that's bus fare. You know, all the other transportation options are actually more pricey. Going by train would be more expensive. Going by plane, I looked at it was like double that, you know. Like $750 was like the cheapest plane fare from New York to Iowa and back. So I was like, shoot, you know, my parents, they just relocated, so they spent a lot of money on relocation. And I had to give them a lot of money for the relocation. So I don't have money. They don't have money. So money is the issue that I couldn't go visit my parents. But that was the plan for Thanksgiving, just to, you know, just enjoy some time off and whatnot. But that didn't happen. So, you know, what's interesting? Interesting things always kind of, I end up having really interesting opportunities on Thanksgiving. And it's true, you know, one Thanksgiving I went over to my friend's place in Connecticut, and I got to meet her family members and we shared wine, and kind of enjoyed her family's Thanksgiving. And then another Thanksgiving, I remember going to my friend who lives in Pennsylvania. So I kind of ended up in places where, you know, I get to help out. For the family in Pennsylvania, I shoveled snow for them, you know, and so I like to kind of volunteer however way I can on Thanksgiving, if I can. You know, it's not a lot of opportunities are there for volunteering for me when I visit those families. You know, usually just like, here, let's enjoy our time together. And that's kind of the spirit of Thanksgiving, that when families celebrate, that's how they do it, hopefully. Thanksgiving is also a time when all the family members gather together, and there's some family Thanksgiving are not as always great. You know, some families have tensions that brew up, and especially if some members of the family have this political or this religious view, and some others have this political or this religious view, and get into discussions, turn into arguments. That can happen on Thanksgiving. And so a lot of the news sites raise blogs like how to talk to your conservative grandfather, or it's like the other one is like how to talk to your liberal college nephews or whatever. You know, that's those are kind of blog topics that trend during this time of the year, which I always find so fascinating that there has to be some kind of guides to that so that families don't end up arguing and fighting each other over Thanksgiving dinner. But that's not something I really have to worry about that much. I mean, my dad and I do get into kind of arguments, but usually we break it off if it gets too intense. We're like, okay, or my dad does, actually. I still want to keep going, but my dad's like, we're not going to continue talking about this. This is over. My dad just, like, shuts down the conversation if it gets too much. Yeah, but this year, I spent my Thanksgiving at a church. Local church, although I guess in New York City, it's local means a whole bunch of different things. It doesn't mean, like, right down the block. For me, local church this year meant a church in Queens. I was there, and this church in Queens is quite big. And they do this event every year in which they serve food to its church members. And it's open to public. So anybody can come and just enjoy food that is shared by the church. And it's a huge event. Like, it was just mind-blowing how they were able to organize this. And how they're able to organize it every year. And in my internship, I was actually calling up a lot of local churches and nonprofits and community-based organizations to ask about, hey guys, you know, if there are homeless people around your area, would you be able to provide meals and feed them? And all the nonprofits was like, no. So, you know, it was mostly just churches that responded well to that. And yeah, it's really the churches that do kind of those direct frontline stuff. And it was amazing. I was at this church and it had meals enough for 1,000 people or more. 1,000 people didn't come, so we had a lot of food left over. But imagine, like, the logistics of that, being able to provide free, amazing hot meals. These were really great meals, by the way. It was macaroni and cheese, turkey, yams, sweet potato, all kinds of sweet potato, beans, rice, salad, roasted vegetables. It had pasta. It had everything. And it was just like, people come. It was open to public. People who needed something to eat for Thanksgiving, homeless people, homeless families and children, all were welcome. And I just went there to volunteer to help serve food. So that's how I spent my Thanksgiving this year. And it felt so great to just be among other people who, church members, who were usually the volunteers. Some people were not really, very few, I think. But most of us were church members. I was not. That was my first time being in that church. You know, my internship, I was calling up churches and local nonprofits, and that's how I ended up there. It was communicated. I was like, oh, that sounds like an amazing thing that you guys are doing. That's wonderful. Very generous of you guys to, you know, be open to serving food to the public in that community. And there are a lot of people in that community who are in need, and some of them who are many of them actually, who are homeless, especially homeless families, mothers and children who are homeless. And so, yeah, they were all welcome to come join in the festivities and just enjoy really great food. And I had a lot of fun just serving the food, preparing the food, and just helping out however we can. I think I was there for about 6 hours or 7 hours. I'm not sure. I wasn't counting. But that's how I spent my Thanksgiving this year. And it was a lot of fun. You know, as a pastor's son, you know, even as a kid, I normally didn't really have a day off on Thanksgiving. So this was a great opportunity for me to kind of keep that going, keep that spirit going, to still be doing something on Thanksgiving instead of just being at home watching Netflix or something. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with spending Thanksgiving by yourself and just enjoying your time by yourself. That's fine too. So, you know, I think plenty of people in the city, in New York City and people like that do that. Some people don't even celebrate Thanksgiving because, you know, because of the history of Thanksgiving or because they have their own religion or belief system that has nothing to do with Thanksgiving. Totally fine. But I just wanted to talk to you guys about how I spent my Thanksgiving this year. And yeah, I be like next year. I don't know why I didn't think to do this sooner, but I think going forward, that's something I should continue to do on Thanksgiving. You know, volunteer at like soup kitchens or churches that provide meals and do stuff. I think Thanksgiving should really be a volunteer activist day for me. I mean, I think that's how I want to transform the holiday for myself. Thanksgiving is a volunteer day, and that's what I'm gonna tell myself from now on. And hopefully, that's what I get to do each year for Thanksgiving Day. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed your day off or had a good spirit at work if you couldn't have a day off. And hope you guys didn't get trampled, you know, shopping at Black Friday if that's your thing. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed, and cheers.